Hi everyone, welcome back. This is John. Today I'm going to show you the Foisonous Spawn in London system. Alright, let's get started. And this is gonna be you can use this one in your game. So let's start with a d4, d2 to d4. This is the start of London system. What if your opponent moves here to knight to f6, isn't it? This knight to f6, this is an ancient game. Let's bring the bishop here. This is the normal London system. So what if your opponent moved to c5? The idea of c5 is to capture or to attack the d pawn in the d pawn. So the only moves here is pawn to e3. The idea of this one is to support the bishop and to support the pawn here in the center. What if the queen moves here in b6? The idea of this one is this to capture this pawn, and this the start in this the game starts. So what you're gonna do, this is the poison pawn. So what we're gonna do is you're going to move the knight to c3. What is that? You're allowing the queen to capture the pawn here in b2. So after, if the black get greedy, so what if the black capture the pawn in b2? What you're gonna do is you need to jump the knight here in b5. What is the main idea here? The main idea is to attack the queen and to attack the rook there. So in order to prevent that attack, so the knight needs to move here in d5, preventing the knight to jump here and attacking the pawn. And there's another attack here, but this is a different variation. Okay, so now let's go back. After the knight moves here to d5, what you're gonna do is you're going to move the pawn here to a3. All right, after that one, so what if the black moves here in a3, attacking the knight? Because I want to remove the knight here because there's an attack here, so that's why your opponent moves the pawn here to a6, attacking the knight. So what's the next move here? The next move here is moving the rook here, attacking the queen. There's no way for the queen to move. The only way is here in a2, because this one is guarded by the knight. So the only move here. All right, so after this one, let's move the queen here to c1. The only idea this one here is to support this one and to support this pawn also. Okay, so what if this is the first variation? What if the pawn captured the knight? The next move is rook to a1, trapping the queen. As you can see here, the queen is already trapped, isn't it? So this is the poison pawn in London system. Let's go back. All right, here we go. So d2 to d4, knight f6, bishop f4. Remember that one? Bishop f4 is a London system. And then your opponent moves the pawn in c5, attacking the pawn in d4. Then the only move here is, the accurate move here is e3. And queen b6, attacking the pawn in b3. And then we're allowing the queen to capture the pawn in b3. That's why we're moving the knight here and knight to c3. After capture the queen b3, we need to hop or jump the knight in b5, attacking the c7 square. The only move here in order to prevent that attack is knight to d5, preventing the knight here in c5. So the next move here is, what we're gonna do is, let's move the pawn here in a3. Okay, so after this one, pawn to a6. The idea here is we need to attack the queen in order to prevent the attack in c7. Okay, so before that one, when the pawn moves to a6, though, the next move is rook to b1, attacking the queen. Here we go, look at this one. Then the only move here is queen to a2. Then let's move the queen to c1, supporting the pawn here if the pawn capture the knight. So the next move, pawn takes knight, then rook to a1. There's no way This one is guarded by the pawn. This is guarded by the bishop. And everything is guarded. The only way here is what? To capture the rook. And let's capture the queen. This is the fastest way. And another strategy or technique and aggressive style for London system. Once again, this is Joan. And thank you for watching. Bye for now.